Hello friends, welcome to video series on geography. My name is Manjunath and this is my blog poemandfriend.org, where you can find text files for all the following videos. In my previous video, I've explained about comparison between various important tectonic theories. So in this video, we'll see about interaction of tectonic plates, which is subheading under plate tectonic theory. So till now, these are the videos I've covered. In tectonics, we have seen about continental drift theory, plate tectonics, and seafloor spreading. Under plate tectonics, we have interaction of plates, and in interaction of plates, we have a major interaction which is a divergent boundary or interaction between two tectonic plates which are moving away from each other. So, under this topic, we'll see about African rift system, which is a very important topic. So, before that, we'll check out few questions which were asked in previous mains examination, which are closely related to interaction of plates. So the first question is, explain the formation of thousands of islands in Indonesian and Philippine archipelago. Why the world's fold mountain systems located along the margins of continents? Bring out the association between global distribution of fold mountains and earthquakes and volcanoes. So both these questions are directly related to convergent plate boundaries. So there were two questions which were asked from convergent plate boundaries in the previous two exams. So in this time or in the future, the important question would be about Great African Rift System as well as the formation of Great African lakes, etc. So this is a very important topic. So, and again, looking at these questions, you can understand the nature of complexity with which UPSC is asking questions in mains. So having a clear conceptual clarity is very important in answering various questions, because you cannot keep on reading about every topic, but still if you have a very good basics, then it will be very easy for you to answer all these kind of questions. So these questions which are directly related to convergent boundary are asked in a very indirect sense, that is, you need to make use of static knowledge and apply that knowledge while answering these questions. So again, conceptual clarity is the key. So this is the distribution of various fold mountains. These are Andes, and then we have Rockies, Himalayas, Urals, and then some mountains of Central Asia like Altai, Tian Shan, etc. And then we have Atlas Mountains, Alps. All these are examples for fold mountains. So all these mountains occur at the plate margins where the movement is convergent, or where two plates converge. And in the other case, there is something called as divergent boundary. For example, what we see along the great ridges, submarine ridges, we mainly observe divergent boundaries where plates move away or against each other. So they don't move towards each other. In this case, we have different kinds of landforms which are created, which are different from mountains or fold mountain systems which are generated due to convergent plate boundaries. So before moving on to divergent plate boundary, let us look at three different types of plate interactions. The first one is divergence, which is also called as constructive edge, because there is a new landform created at the divergent edges. And then we have constructive plate boundary, and along constructive plate boundary there is destruction of the existing landform. As a result, this is called as destructive edge. And there is transform boundary, where two plates slide against each other, and here there is no destruction or creation of landforms, only certain deformations happen. So the best example is San Andreas fault. And this is the best and like a very popular example. And for convergent edge, we have examples like the convergence between Indian plate and Eurasian plate. And for divergence, we have the divergence between African and Somalian minor plate, about which we'll be studying in this video. So coming to divergent plate boundary, in my previous videos, I've explained about the forces which are directly responsible for plate movements. The forces are generated by convectional cells which are happening in mantle, as we can see in this picture. In mantle, there are convectional cells. So when there is rising limbs which approach the plate margins, there is extreme amount of pressure in this region. And in such a case, there is always a weak spot for volcanic eruptions. And also the convection cells drag these two plates away from each other, as a result creating room for the volcanic eruptions. So this is what we have seen under seafloor spreading. So we'll see in much more detail in this topic about the whole formation of rifting and then which will give rise to linear sea, and which linear sea finally converting into vast ocean. So the main driving force are the convection cells. So this is, in this picture, what you can see is submarine ridge, and on the both sides there is seafloor spreading. So this is example for divergent plate boundary, what we can see here. I have explained about in this in previous videos. And before studying divergent edge, we need to know about faulting. So I've explained faulting also in my previous videos, that is in Earth's interior, I guess. So in faulting, we have three different kinds of faulting. One is normal fault, and then we have reverse faulting, and the other one is transcurrent fault. Normal fault mainly occurs due to tensile forces, where outward movement of two different blocks of earth gives rise to subsidence of the block in between. This is called as normal faulting. And the compressive forces gives rise to reverse faulting, where a block is uplifted due to compression from the other two blocks. And in transcurrent fault, just like in transcurrent edge, what we see is the sliding or collision of grinding of two blocks of earth, and this is a very rare kind of phenomena, whereas the most normally observed one is normal faulting. So in this video, we are mostly concerned about normal faulting and reverse faulting. So before studying about rift system as well as the creation of vast oceans, we need to start from the basics, how divergent boundary plays a role in the formation of all these landforms. So this is divergence of two different plates. We have seen about convection cells, which are responsible for divergence. So at the divergence process, during the divergence process, due to convection cells, the two plates move away from each other, and also there is good weak spot available for the magma to flow out. And both this outward movement of plates as well as the mantle plumes or huge magma cell at very high temperature and pressure are responsible for deformation of the surface. This deformation is called as upwrapping. So this is the upwrapping. And during upwrapping, the major changes that occurs are normal faulting and reverse faulting. So previously I've explained what is normal faulting and reverse faulting. So during upwrapping, we mainly see both normal faulting and reverse faulting. So in normal faulting, what we have is a block which slides in between two blocks, whereas in reverse faulting, we have a block which raises upwards when compared to the other two blocks. So the ones that are raised ones are called as hosts, whereas the ones which are at lesser heights are called as gravens. So in this example, this is graben and the other two are hosts. So in the formation of in the deformation or upwrapping process, what we observe are the formation of both gravens and hosts. And the next stage is rift formation. So this is rift formation. In rift formation, what we see is a greater outward movement of plates, which results in greater mantle plumes. And also, due to mainly normal faulting, there is a lot of subsidence of landforms, which creates rifts in between. Or this is graben surrounded by two hosts. This is horse, H-O-R-S-T-S. So this is the stage in which we see a rift formation. For example, African rift is in this stage. And there are seas like Red Sea and Gulf of Aden, which are in a much advanced stage. That is, they are linear seas, where there is much greater movement of these plates. That is, they diverge in a very large distances, and which results in accumulation of water, giving rise to a very narrow, somewhat narrow and shallow seas. The best examples are Red Sea and Gulf of Aden. So for example, both Rift Valley of Africa as well as the narrow sea or linear sea of Red Sea have all been formed due to same process of rifting, or what we can see as a divergent plate boundaries. But still, due to different pace or different interaction at different intensities between these two plates, we can see that the Rift Valley is still at a stage of rift formation, whereas the other one, Red Sea, has already reached a stage of linear sea formation. And then after the linear sea, what we have is a wide ocean floor, what we see in Atlantic and Pacific oceans. So before even these things were formed, mainly in this process, we can see the first stage is upwrapping, and then we have rift, and then linear sea, and then we have major oceans. And at present, these seas undergoes seafloor spreading, as we have seen in previous videos. So this is the foundation for understanding African Rift System. So before studying African Rift System, we should understand the different kinds of plates which are involved in African Rift System. The major plates are the African Continental Plate, which is also called as Nubian Plate, and the Somalian Minor Plate, which mainly consists of ocean and some parts of Somalia, Tanzania, Kenya and Madagascar. And there is one more important plate, which is Arabian Plate. This is also a minor plate, which is a part of Eurasian Plate. So there is constant interaction between these three plates, and this interaction have given rise to this great rift system of both Africa, which covers both Africa as well as some parts, small parts of Asia. So the rift starts at around Jordan. It extends till the Agar region in Ethiopia and then continues along the Gulf of Aden. This sea is called as Gulf of Aden. And then it extends as Ethiopian rift into Africa. And then we have two rifts. One is called as Albertine Rift. This is Albertine Rift, the western side rift. And the eastern rift is called as Kenyan Rift. And this rift is extended till the river basin of Zambezi. So river Zambezi flows here. So till there we have this entire rift system, which is about few thousand kilometers in length. So this rift system is very important because there are very important lakes which are formed due to the process of rifting, and these lakes supply water to one of the world's very important rivers, which is Nile. So this is roughly the path of Nile, and the water for Nile comes from mainly two tributaries. One is Blue Nile, other one is White Nile. White Nile receives water from lakes, that is Lake Tanganyika and Albert and Irwin, etc. So all these lakes supply water to the White Nile tributary. And then for Blue Nile tributary, the major water comes from Ethiopian highlands. So Ethiopian highlands are present in this region. So these islands and lakes are very important from geography or geology perspective. So if you come to the formation of African Rift Valley, we have seen how these plates interact. For example, Arabian Plate and the African or Nubian Plate move away from each other, giving rise to Red Sea, which is a linear sea. So this is the linear sea stage. And when we move to Gulf of Aden, even this is the linear sea. And then what we have, a very important landform called as Ethiopian Islands. Ethiopian Islands are very similar to Deccan Traps in kind of formation, because they are both are formed due to fissure type volcanoes, where there is huge amount of volcanic output. Actually, this is shield type. Ethiopian Islands are shield type, whereas Deccan Traps is fissure type. Mostly they are both similar, but Ethiopian Islands are quite higher compared to Deccan Traps. So we have seen in this stage, after the rifting, before the rifting process, what we have is very high pressure mantle plumes. And when there is huge amount of volcanic output from these small fractures, then there is huge amount of basaltic magma coming, and which spreads through a very great distances, giving rise to a huge plateau like structure of this basaltic magma. So Ethiopian islands are the ones which are formed in this manner. And then next we have the important ones are Albertine Rift and then Kenyan Rift. So they vary in nature mainly because Albertine Rift has greater lakes, main most important lakes like Lake Tanganyika and then Lake Albert Irwin, and then one more lake here, it is called as Lake Malawi. So all these lakes are formed along Albertine Rift, whereas Mount Kenya, Mount Kilimanjaro and various other volcanic mountains are formed along this rift, which is called as Kenyan Rift, which bisects bifurcates Kenyan region. So this rift is mostly spread across countries like Rwanda. There are like Burundi and various countries, like again we have Kenya, and then we have Tanzania, Ethiopia, Ethiopia, etc. So if we see the formation of lakes are formed in similar way to the formation of this thing called as Ethiopian Islands, except that in Ethiopian Islands there is outflowing of magma, which gives rise to shield type volcano, whereas in the formation of lakes there is no shield type volcano, there is only rifting. So after upwrapping, what we have is rifting, and in the rifting process we see these plates moving away from each other, and there is certain amount of land which is subsiding. This is called as normal fault, and this normal fault created huge depressions. Though there is huge magma which is at great pressure, but this pressure is relieved in the form of movement of plates, and there is some certain type of relief in this pressure because of the formation of mountains like Mount Kenya, Mount Kilimanjaro, etc. So there is a kind of depression formed due to rifting process. This is called S, and the block which goes towards the center of Earth is called as graben, whereas other rocks, other parts are called as horse, H-O-R-S-T-S, horse. So in this case, the lakes were formed mainly due to rifting where the subsidence of land has taken place. For example, Lake Tanganyika, which is the longest lake in the world, freshwater lake, longest freshwater lake in the world, has formed in this process due to rifting between these two plates, that is Somali plate and Nubian plate. So there is one more important lake called as Lake Victoria in the region. It is formed due to minor rifting, which happens in this direction between the Kenyan fault and Albertine fault. So this rifting has given rise to Lake Victoria, which is the biggest, largest freshwater lake in Africa and the second largest freshwater lake in the world after Lake Superior. So there is one more important lake called Lake Baikal in Russia. So even that's a very important lake. So compare between these three lakes. So if you just look at the next stage, usually after a few million years from now, this rifting will give rise to linear sea, as we can see. So the Somali plate will completely move away from Africa. So the Nubian plate will be separated from Somali plate. And what we see this feature is called as linear sea. And further extension would give rise to much bigger ocean-like region. And if we see the extension of the Rift Valley usually covers all these regions. It is up to the western parts of India. So this is all about divergent plate boundary and the Rift Valley system. And in this, the most important concept, at least when writing answers, the most important concept would be the plates. One is Somali plate and the Nubian plate and Arabian plate and the interaction between these plates. So it is important to remember the names of these plates and which plate gave rise to which kind of movement. For example, at this region, in this kind of here the plate interaction gave rise to huge lakes called Lake Tanganyika, Lake Albert, etc. So, but in Ethiopian highlands, we've seen about shield type volcano. So interaction at different parts have given rise to different landforms. So it is important to remember all these kinds of landforms. And again, it is very important to remember the location of lakes and other important geographical features, which I'll be dealing in detail in while studying about world geography and then location based questions. So here we don't need more confusion. We need to understand only about Earth's the Great African Rift Valley System. So all this part is called as East African Rift System, whereas the extension is called as Total Great Rift System. So this is just a sad pictures which can give you a much more bigger view. So this is Ethiopian Islands, and then what we have Mount Kilimanjaro and Mount Kenya. This is Kilimanjaro and then Mount Kenya, and then this is Lake Tanganyika, and then we have Lake Victoria. So we need to study about facts about these lakes. Previously I have told, but I still doubt the accuracy of what I have said. So please confirm these things through net. So thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. I'll be putting more videos on geography. So I have uploaded notes on physical geography in my blog. You can take a look at that. Almost entire physical geography has been covered. And keep following my blog, where I'll be uploading various important notes for UPSC Civil Services examination. And thanks for watching. Please subscribe.